everyone. So this is the last part of photosynthesis, and in this lesson we'll be discussing about the C4 pathway and the CAM pathway. So let us first of all discuss about the CAM pathway. So the CAM pathway is also given the name of Hatch and Slack pathway, and this C4 cycle is given the name C4 because the first stable compound that is formed in this cycle is known as OAA, that is oxaloacetate, which is a 4-carbon compound. And this cycle mainly occurs in the plants of the temperate region. Example, maize, sorghum, sugarcane and corn. And this pathway is mainly adapted by the plants in order to avoid photorespiration, about which we have already discussed in the previous video. The two most important adaptations that these plants shows for avoiding the photorespiration are, the first one is the dimorphic chloroplast, and then we have the Crans anatomy. So let's look at that, what is dimorphic and what is Crans anatomy. So dimorphic means something having two forms. Di means two and morphic means the form. So the chloroplast having different forms is known as a dimorphic chloroplast. So in these type of plants there are two types of chloroplast found. The first one is the A granule and the second one is the granule. The A granule ones are found in the bundle sheet cells and the granule ones are found in the mesophyll cells. A granule means a chloroplast devoid of the granas. So what was a grana? We have already studied. The grana were the coin-like structures present in the matrix of the chloroplast. And the granule means the chloroplast having the grana. And the second adaptation is the Crans anatomy. So the word Crans means a writ-like circular arrangement. So as you can see in the figure that there is circular arrangement of the mesophyll cells and also the bundle sheath cells. Hence, this type of anatomy is known as a Crans anatomy. And why does these plants show these adaptations? In order to compartmentalize the concentration of carbon dioxide so that the rubisco can work as a carboxygenase. Because in the previous video we have studied that the main condition for the photorespiration to occur was because of the presence of high concentration of oxygen. So this adaptation of Crans anatomy and the dimorphic chloroplast play the most important role in order to ensure that the rubisco have carbon dioxide concentration in its surrounding so that it can work as a carboxygenase. So let us look at the pathway now. The first point to remember is about the Crans anatomy and the dimorphic chloroplast. So the cycle works this way. It is the carbon dioxide which enters into the mesophyll cells via the stomata, and after entering it reacts with the water in order to form HCO3-, that is bicarbonate ions, and these bicarbonate ions react with PEP, that is phosphoenol pyruvate, in the presence of the enzyme PEPCO, which stands for phosphoenol pyruvate carboxylase, to form the first stable compound, that is oxaloacetate or oxaloacetic acid. And this oxaloacetic acid converts into the malic acid, which is then transported to the bundle sheath cells. And here, by the elimination of carbon dioxide, malic acid gets converted into the pyruvate, which is transported back to the mesophyll cells. And after reaching the mesophyll cells, this pyruvate gets converted back to the PEP, that was phosphoenol pyruvate, so that the cycle can continue in a normal manner. The most important point to remember is that the eliminated carbon dioxide help the rubisco enzyme to work as a carboxygenase, and continue the C3 cycle in order to form the glucose without wasting much of the ATP as in the case of photorespiration. So, by this process, the C4 plants have compartmentalized the carbon dioxide concentration around the Rubisco enzyme in the bundle sheath cells. So, this was the complete pathway. Now, let us look at the CAM pathway. So, the CAM pathway means crassulacean acid metabolism. And this pathway is mainly seen in the plants that grow in the dry area where there is shortage of water. For example, the succulents and the xerophytes. And the adaptations is the scotoactive stomata. Scotoactive stomata means the stomatas which remain open at night, which leads to less water loss, helping the plant to survive in less water areas. So, let us look at the pathway now. So, this pathway and the previous C4 cycle pathway are almost the similar one with only few differences. The first difference that is seen in the CAM pathway is the scotoactive stomata. That means at night the stomatas are open and in the daytime the stomatas are closed. So, during the night time when the stomatas are open, the carbon dioxide enters via the open stomatas and in the same manner as in the C4 pathway, it reacts with water to form H2CO3, which gets split down into the bicarbonate ions, and these bicarbonate ions combines with PEP in order to form the same oxaloacetic acid, which gets converted into the malic acid. The difference occurs at this step, and the difference is that this malic acid, which is produced in the night time, gets stored in the vacuole. It is very important to remember that where it is stored, because it has been asked previously. So remember, it is the vacuole where the malic acid is stored at night. And during the daytime, when the stomatas are closed, from the vacuole, the malic acid comes out and gets converted into PEP. And in the same manner as the previous cycle, the carbon dioxide is released. And this carbon dioxide gets into the C3 cycle in order to form the glucose. And for the C3 cycle, the ATP and the NADPH2 are produced via the light reaction, about which we have already discussed. So with this, we are done with the C4 pathway and the CAM pathway. So now let us discuss a question. The main purpose to add this question was to make you understand that even without knowing the complete information about the question, it is easy to solve a question by using elimination method, and second, by memorizing simple highlighted points in the topics. So in this question, it is asked about the carbon dioxide assimilation, and even if you do not read these three points and read just the fourth point, that is saying that the malic acid during the CAM is stored in the mitochondria during the dark and released back to the cytosol during the day. But we know that it is not the mitochondria but the vacuole where the malic acid was being stored. We can easily eliminate this, and on eliminating the D option, we can easily cut out these three options and get to the final answer, that is answer A. So with this, we are done with the complete process of the photosynthesis. We have covered the process in very detail, step by step. You can go through the complete playlist. It has 7 parts for the complete structured understanding of the concept. So, if you like this video, please do like, share it with your friends, and please subscribe to my channel. It would be very helpful. And I'll be coming up soon with the next fresh topic very soon. And till then, keep learning.